I built an automated 24/7 live stream where the viewers decide what two AI characters argue about. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how I built this, as well as some issues that I ran into.
How can you support capitalism?
Listen, SpongeBob, you live in a pineapple under the sea.
Something I'll always remember is Twitch plays Pokemon all the way back in 2014. And now that generative AI has completely taken over everything, this concept of a viewer-controlled stream has just exploded with AI-generated SpongeBob, Family Guy, or Seinfeld. So I thought of an idea. It would be cool if we could create a software where two AIs that represent a character are arguing against each other in a specific topic and have their voices reflect what they're talking about. And if we live stream this on Twitch and let the users decide who the characters are or what they're arguing about, it'd be a lot more fun and interactive that way. Perfect. How do we get started though? First, we need to create two instances of an AI chat model running. We then think of two random characters, for example, SpongeBob and Mario. We will then need to get as much information on these characters as possible. So we'll go online, hopefully Wikipedia, and get a full extensive history to build up their knowledge of what they'll base their opinions on. This will then be chopped up into segments and then embedded within a vector database. We will have AI also generate two opposing views based on a subject and then query this information in both AIs to gather their opinion. Then using another AI, we'll generate a script that will be read over by both characters. The AI voice cloner will run in parallel and be able to get the voiceover while the script is generating. The lines will be generated and organized in a sequence to seem like they're talking back and forth. The biggest priority of this project is going to be speed, especially considering there's a lot of long waits in response to making this work, including the data gathering, the voice generation, and even the script generating. For the text generation, I'm going to use OpenAI, as they actually just released a GPT-4 Turbo that has over 128K token window. This will make it easy for us to do off of our computer to make things go faster and hopefully in parallel. So I got the Wikipedia article for SpongeBob, and I'm just going to paste in the system message here. Oh, hi there. Golly, that's a big question. Well, you know, Bikini Bottom, we kind of have our own little economy. Capitalism sure does encourage folks to work hard, innovate, and it's all about the... I'm doing a SpongeBob accent right now. It's just funny thinking about SpongeBob actually saying this, so already it's beyond hilarious. Let's just set up a Python project. On my channel, I'm always creating insane projects like automating TikTok accounts or giving trading bots that I built $10,000. Building projects is the best way to learn. So if you want to learn, I would highly recommend you check out Zero to Mastery, which I found to be one of the most efficient and supportive way for you to learn in-demand tech skills and actually get hired. Or like me, if you just want to build some awesome projects. I learned how to use LangChain to develop parts of this app with a build an LLM powered Q&A app using LangChain to understand how I can integrate it within my own apps. And with their large catalog of courses, as well as the portfolio projects for you to build, there's a lot you can do than just a to-do app to put on your portfolio. And you can seriously go down a deep rabbit hole if this is something you want to get a really deep understanding of. Like, for example, if you want to understand TensorFlow or PyTorch to start fine-tuning your models. If you know absolute zero about code, there are courses designed to get you started. I like this career path finder that helps you determine what your roadmap would be based on the interests you have. And these aren't separate courses that you have to buy individually. It's all one cost that gives you access to everything in their catalog, which are all updated to be ready and relevant for 2024. And it's not even 2024 yet. On my channel, I like to build projects or create videos that help inspire you to make something cool. But if you really want to learn how you can do it, I couldn't recommend Zero to Mastery enough. If you click on the link in the description below, you can help support the channel as well as invest in your career in tech, all with a 30-day money-back guarantee if it just isn't for you. Thank you, Zero to Mastery, for being a longtime sponsor of this channel, as well as letting me copy and paste your code. I actually think this might be one of the hardest parts about this project, finding a way to get all of the information. And after doing a search online, I couldn't find a way to get this information in one centralized place through like an API or something. So I'm gonna have to resort to the old fashioned way of doing things, scraping data. I'm gonna write a quick script that lets me do a web search for a character and fandom, where we can get information related to the character by fans. Since we have the 128K version of GPT-4, we might not even need a vector database for this, so let's just make a check to see if the text being inserted isn't over 128K tokens. So let's find a way to create a script for them to talk. I'll be using LangChain to create a chain of conversation that they can have with each other. LangChain was really overwhelming at first, but I caught up quickly using the Zero to Mastery's LLM project video and was able to jump in fine. This is how my script works. I prompt bot 1 to say an opening line. This makes the conversation sound like the bot is making an observation about a subject right off the bat. This message is then passed to bot 2, who replies with their opinion on the subject. This then gets passed to bot 1, who has context of what they said previously, and we loop over this 5 or 6 times. And this actually gives us the text that we need to run this through the text-to-voice processor so that they can actually argue in a voice rather than just text. Hey there, Tony. I'm totally stoked to discuss capitalism with you. Even though it's kind of out of my usual zone of jellyfishing and serving Krabby Patties at the Krusty Krab. Listen, SpongeBob, you're a good kid, I get it. You're optimistic, you flip your burgers, and you think capitalism is this big Krabby Patty cook-off where the best chef wins. I had to cut it down a little bit, but I mean, pretty freaking funny. We have to find a way to get a clean sample of their voice so that we can prompt it into the voice cloner. How do we do that though? Well, I think I found a solution that will work. Using diarization, this is able to recognize speaker to each word in a transcript. So I will query character compilation and then run the audio file through the diarization. So there might be a ton of characters that aren't related to ours in this video, but we'll query all of the lines mentioned by one of the characters that shows up the most, which I assume is our main character. As of this video, the current state of AI voices is that tortoise or koki. How do I say that dang word?
Koki.
So I'm first gonna try out with some of the open source versions. So I'm gonna first try out Bark. I also realized that with PyTorch, I can let them know to use my CUDA cores on my NVIDIA 4090, thanks to the Zero to Mastery cheat sheet. So thank you for that.
You need to listen to me good. Stop talking about capitalism like it's a good thing.
It took a little bit long and I'm overall not too happy with it, especially if I wanna run a lot of these in parallel to make it go faster. Instead, I'm going to use an API service for much faster results. One of the most popular paid options is 11 Labs, but honestly, if I wanted to do as many voices as I wanted to do, I would need to be an enterprise level user. And look at this setup. Nothing enterprise about it. One of the most powerful open source version of the text to voice model is XTTS. And they actually just released a version 2 as of like a couple weeks ago, as of this video. And the maintainers of this model, Koki AI, have Koki Studio, which I had to go on Discord and ask if it supported the XTTS V2, which it does. So let's test out SpongeBob and Tony's first lines.
Hey there, Tony. I'm totally stoked to discuss capitalism with you.
It's funny because SpongeBob sounds like a woman's voice. I wonder if it thought that's what it was.
Hey there, Tony. I'm totally stoked to discuss capitalism with you.
I mean, it comes out pretty funny. Honestly, it's not bad. For what it is, I'm happy with it. Let me try Tony now.
Listen, SpongeBob, you're a good kid, I get it. You're optimistic, you flip your burgers, and you think capitalism is this big Krabby Patty cook-off where the best chef wins.
Honestly, that was much better. Now we have to find a way to put this all together. Now this for sure will be the hardest part because we want this to be really fast and we can do a lot of things in parallel. We'll be getting the input of the characters in the conflict at the same time, grab the character information if we don't already have it off of fandom, grab the character's voice from a voice clip online, generate the opposing views on the specific subject. And after that, that's when we start depending on things from those steps that are just mentioned. Once the character's information has been retrieved and the opposing views have generated, let the boss generate a script that we can have. Once the voice clip is finished, we then need to take our script and run it through the text-to-speech. Each voice clip then needs to be played in sequence with subtitles for the viewer to follow along. Now the script itself needs some work. This just feels very formal. I want them to feel like they're arguing with each other rather than just having a long, thoughtful debate that's, you know, being moderated or something. All right, back for day 2, and yep, I just got a haircut, so that's how you know it's a different day. So I just ended up using the OpenAI function calling parameters to make sure that I can just do the whole entire script in one batch. It still works similar to how I've done it before, but instead uses one API call rather than a bunch in order to do
it. Tony, I just don't get it. How can you support capitalism when it creates so much inequality in the world?
Listen, SpongeBob. You live in a pineapple under the sea. You don't see things the way they are up here. Capitalism is about the American dream.
But, Tony, not everyone gets the same chance. Look at the Krusty Krab and the Chum Bucket. Mr. Krabs thrives because he's been given opportunities that Plankton has.
That's just the way the cookie crumbles, kid. And who's Plankton? Sounds like a loser to me. You gotta be tough to survive. That's the world.
Yeah, I mean, that just is way better than what it was before. So I'm really happy with the way it turned out. All right, we haven't even touched one of the most crucial parts. My goal for this Twitch live stream is every 30 seconds, a poll pops up and lets people use a command to suggest what they want to see next. This then adds to a queue to trigger our script to get all of the assets and compile it so that it's ready to play when the one in front is done. My reason for doing this is because I want the viewer to feel involved, but not have to wait like an hour for their suggestions to pop up. Well, in theory, it's my software, so who knows? We create a Twitch bot that accepts all user input for a certain period of time. We then have a middleman server between the Twitch bot and the website that will be broadcasting on Twitch. This server will pass the messages to the script we made to generate content and also send messages to the website so that viewers can stay updated at all times. The Twitch bot was really easy thanks to Twitch.io, so shout out to the maintainers of that package. It was really easy. And to connect all three areas, we're going to use WebSockets. A lot of work, so let's go. And it works. Thank God. It's only me talking to myself in the chat. Loser. Now let's run the final command to give it a shot.
That's just a bunch of beeping and booping. Give me some classic rock anything.
Come on, Homer.
It really did turn out pretty awesome. So I'm pretty happy with the result. I mean, it's a bit dodgy a little bit because, you know, a lot of the characters are hard to find and the audio results are not always perfect, but it's pretty funny either way, even if it doesn't work. Here's some of my favorite scenarios that turned out.
There's no doubt that PewDiePie is the king of YouTube. The master of memes is unstoppable.
Oh, please, Homer. Everyone knows that Dude Perfect are the YouTube goats. They've got the most epic trick shots and stunts.
Yeah.
That's the right choice for you over his, but in the Force, balance we must find. Under, maintain the balance, it does.
Come on. Over is practical, it's user-friendly, and it's... Are we still talking about toilet paper?
God, have you?
Look, Optimus, everyone knows it's pronounced GIF. It's like a peanut butter brand, all right?
With all due respect, the creator of the format says it's GIF with a hard G. It stands for Graphics Interchange Format, not Graphics Interchange Format.
Oh, come on, Optimus. Are you gonna tell me the guy who invented it gets to decide how to say it? That's just crazy talk.
As creators define the essence of their creations, it is only logical to follow his guidance.
You can check the stream in the description below, check it out, and if it breaks, then, I mean, it is what it is. It's my software at the end of the day. The amount of AI tools that's available to us is incredible, to say the least. I'm really impressed by the current state of AI and open source, like with XTTS or even smaller text-to-speech models. New AI models on Huggingface came out like almost daily while I was making this video, and I had so many more ideas that I wanted to pursue. Apart from that, the amount of technology I had to incorporate into this app, like servers, Python, APIs, WebSockets, JavaScript, crazy. And if you want to learn code to build weird things like this, well, make sure you check out Zero to Mastery, who can teach you all of this and more. Linked below. If you're watching this like a week later from when I posted this, you can find the source code in the link below. Don't judge though, the code might be a mess, but you know, beggars can't be choosers. If you like me building these weird things, then make sure you check out my Reddit bot or check out the $10,000 trading bot I made that trades stocks based off of Taylor Swift lyrics.